There are six options under the speed sensor drop-down box for 4L60, 65, 70, 80, and 85E transmissions. The 4L60E output shaft speed sensor is an extension housing mounted unit with a 40 pulse tone ring on the output shaft. It is used in transmissions and transfer cases that don't have a mechanical speedometer drive. This is the best output shaft speed sensor to use when a mechanical speedometer drive isn't needed. In 4L80E transmissions, the output shaft speed sensor is located towards the rear of the main case and is identical to the input shaft speed sensor, which is located towards the front. Both are on the left side. Some 4L80E transmissions from 4x4 vehicles don't have the output shaft speed sensor tone ring. In those cases, you will need to either disassemble the transmission to install the tone ring or use a speed sensor in the transfer case. A similar type of 40 pulse sensor can be used in transfer cases that don't have a mechanical speedometer drive. An example of the early and late style sensor is shown to the right of the drop-down box. The large connector is used in early 4L60E transmissions and transfer cases, while the narrow sensor is only used in the later 4L60E extension housing and 4L80Es that have a tone ring installed on the output shaft. The 6-bolt extension housing is only used with the 2-piece removable bell housing case and doesn't have a mechanical speedometer drive option. All 4L60Es with the 6-bolt extension housing will use the narrow speed sensor connector. The GM gear-driven speedo cable style sensor was only used in a few applications and is becoming hard to find. Check the picture to the right to confirm that it's the one on your transmission. The speedometer gear attaches to the sensor and the speedometer cable attaches to its exterior. In the lower boxes, you will need to enter the speedo drive teeth and driven teeth numbers if using this sensor. The sensor can be mounted in a transfer case or any early style extension housing with mechanical speedometer drive provisions. The next option is for an aftermarket 8-pulse cable drive sensor, such as the Dakota Digital unit. It can be mounted to a transfer case or early extension housing with mechanical speedometer drive provisions. In the lower boxes, you will need to enter the speedo drive teeth and driven teeth numbers. Refer to the description for more details and part numbers that will help you identify the sensor. The fourth option is for an Autometer VDO 16-pulse cable drive sensor. These sensors provide 16 pulses per speedo cable revolution. They are usually Hall effect type units, so the Hall effect square wave option should be selected and the output sensor test checkbox at the bottom should be disabled. This style sensor can be mounted to a transfer case or early extension housing with mechanical speedometer drive provisions. In the lower boxes, you will need to enter the speedo drive teeth and driven teeth numbers. Refer to the description for more details and part numbers that will help you identify the sensor. If you're using a 1997 or later Corvette differential speed sensor, choose that option from the drop-down box. These use 40 pulses per ring gear revolution. The last option is for custom speed sensors. These could be custom fabricated or non-standard sensors on the output shaft, drive shaft, or rear axle. Enter the specifications for your sensor and choose the sensor type from the bottom drop-down box. For all sensor types, you will need to enter your vehicle's rear axle ratio and tire diameter. You should also make sure the correct tachometer input type is selected based on your vehicle's ignition type.